Hello students. So students, in the previous class in this chapter, that is living things and their surrounding, we were talking about the surrounding. It means we were talking about the adaptation. So we have started we have started with that of the habitat, and in which we have started with that of the terrestrial habitat. And in the terrestrial habitat, we have already discussed about that of the desert habitat, that how the animals and the plants, they adapt themselves so that they can survive in that desert habitat. Okay, so they consisting of some special feature, and due to which they are able to survive there. Then the second thing that we have started to understand, that okay, so the adaptation in the desert is we already had discussed, and then we have seen the adaptation that occur in case of the mountain region. So what kind of features the animals or the plants, they have developed themselves to sustain or to live in that certain habitat. You see students, we had discussed the animals like that of the snow leopard, yak is also there, mountain goat is there. So what are the challenges they face to live in such condition, and how they overcome with their challenge? Okay, so having that special feature make it to live in such condition. You see student, if we talk about the mountain goats, we have seen that first of all the condition is very cold, it is an extreme cold climate. So they must have the features that they can protect their body from the cold. For that they are having hair on their body. Okay, so this hair will make them to help them to protect from the cold climate. Then the second thing, that a mountain goat means they have to jump, they have to move from one rock slope to the other rocky slope for grazing purpose. So they must have that features so that they can do that. So for this they are having strong hooves. Okay, so very rough feet are there, strong hooves are there, and which help them to move from one rocky slope to the other easily. If you talk about the snow leopard students, so snow leopard, the name itself explains snow leopard, it means they are living in a mountain or a hill. So they are having furs, and this fur will help them to protect their body. Second thing, they are having fats in their body. And this fat, it acts as a cover, it acts as an insulator, which insulate the body, which help in maintaining the heat in the body. Then when they walk, their feet will also feel the cold. So for that, the fur is also present at the toes or feet. And not only this, the feet are very large so that it will apply very less amount of a weight on the snow and not make them to sink in the snow. Okay, so these are some of the features which make them to alive, which makes them to survive in such extreme conditions also. Now let us see the third terrestrial habitat, and that is forest or grassland. Okay, so forest or grasslands. Okay, so how the organism, they are able to live in forest or the grassland. So let us see that what is there in the grassland or forest. So most of the place is covered with the trees, large trees are there, plants are there, and that is why the name itself is a forest, or the grasses are there students, so grassland. Okay, so we can write it that way. A large area is covered with trees and plants. Okay, so large area is covered with the trees and plants, and that is called a forest. What about the definition of the grassland? So large area of grass covered. Okay, large area is covered with the grass, called
grassland.
Okay, so we can say that if the area is totally covered with the trees and that of the plants, so we use the term for that is forest. We are very well known about the forest is what? Many trees are there, many plants are there. That is the forest. And grassland, it means the area is covered with the grasses, the land is covered with the grass, that is the grassland. Okay. So in case of the grassland, you can see that very very few amount of plant is there for the animals to hide themselves from their predators. Okay, so the thing that how they can protect themselves from their predator, from their enemies, that they should run away. Okay, so they must have the features that they can protect themselves from the predators, especially if we talking about the case of the grassland. Okay, so we can say that here speed is important. The animal must have a speed. Okay, speed is important for them to survive, to move in the grassland area. So let us see that what are the different kind of adaptations shown by the animals which are living in this grassland or in the forest area. So let us start with the adaptation in lion. You know that the lion, they used to live in the forest or in the grassland area. So first of all, we move and see the adaptation in lion. Adaptation in lion students. So basically lion, what is a lion? Lion is a carnivorous animal. It means it need food, it need flesh of the other animals, or it depend upon the other animals for their food. Okay, so we can say that lion are the carnivorous animals. It is a carnivorous, eat the meat of the other animal or the flesh of the other animal. Eat flesh of other animals. That is why it is a carnivorous only. And the next one is that lives in the forest. So if it is living in the forest, it has adapted itself in such a way that it can live in the forest. So some features it has adapted. So we can write it that is, thus, it has adapted itself to live in forest. You see students, what we are talking about here, we are talking about the forest or the grassland, and we are discussing the adaptation that is shown by the lion. Is how lion make itself so that it can live in the forest or forest area or the forest habitat. So first of all, we should know that lion is what? It is a carnivorous animal, so it totally depend upon the other animals, flesh or meat of the other animals. The food is the flesh or the meat of other animals, and it live in the forest. So it has made its, it has generated some special features, and due to which it is able to live in the forest place only. So the first thing that it is very strong, fast, and agile. Okay, so strong, fast, and agile. So if it is a strong, if it is a fast, so it is able to kill its prey, like that of a deer is there, or a cow is there, or any other animals are there which is living inside that of the forest. So the first feature is it is very fast. I told you when we had started with this, we said that in a grassland or in a forest, speed is important if you want to protect themselves. Okay, so we can say that lion is very fast. Fast, It is very fast, then strong and agile. Strong, fast and agile animal which can hunt or kill its prey. Which can hunt or kill its prey. Like deer. Deer is there, student. Cow is there, lot more are there which used to get eaten up or which is a prey for that of the lion. Okay, so it is fast, it is a strong and agile which make it to survive in the forest place or in the forest area. Okay, so you can see here that we said that the lion is what? It is fast, it is strong and agile animal which is having the tendency, which is having the capacity to kill its prey or hunt its prey. Now the second adaptation that we will going to see in case of the lion is, that is so the second one, students, is that it is having very long, very sharp claws. So what is the use of the claws here? So basically the long and the sharp claws will help it to catch the prey. Okay, so for catching the prey it is having the sharp claws. Okay, so we can write it that the lion has strong, it is having strong, long and sharp claws. Long, strong and sharp claws in front of the legs to catch the prey. In front of the legs to catch its prey. Okay, so to catch its prey, it is having the long, it is having strong and sharp claws. Okay, now not only this, basically what happened, it used to withdraw, means it is having a tendency that it can withdraw its claws in the paws. Okay, so we can also say that it used to pull in the claws in the paws, in the toes, when it is not ready to catch, and it will take it out when it will going to catch the prey. Okay, so we can also write it here, and that is the lion can withdraw. Meaning of the withdraw is here, that is pulled in. Okay, pull in, withdraw or pull in the claws. Pull in the claws inside it. Inside the toes. Okay, it is having it can withdraw the claws inside to that of the toes, that which will also help the claws not to torn out. You see that if suppose it is always if it is outside, so chances is there that while moving and while running it will going to torn that of the claws. So to protect it, what they used to do, they used to pull in, withdraw it in the toes. Okay, so that they do not worn out they do not worn out, they do not worn out and blunt. You see students, that basically they are able to hold air, they are able to catch its prey with the help of the claws, and the reason is that they are strong, they are sharp also. So they want to maintain that this sharpness, and how they are able to do so, by protecting the claws. And how it will going to protect the claws, student? By keeping it inside, in the toes, when it is not in the net, okay, when they are not going to catch a prey. Okay, so when they will going to catch the prey, only then they will take out the claws, or otherwise it will pull it in the toes, and which will help in maintaining, which will help in keeping the claws safe. It will help in preventing the worn out, it will help in preventing the claws to become blunt. Okay, so to maintain the sharpness of the claws, they used to keep it, they used to pull it inside the toes. Okay, so this is the second adaptation that is shown by the loin. Now, the third one is, students, that they are having eyes, and this eyes is in front of the head. Okay, so in front, eyes in front of its head, which enable it to see its prey very easily. So the eyes which is present at the front, which it help it to enable the location of the prey. Okay, only then they are able to hunt, or they are able to kill the prey. Next one is that the loin has eyes. Loin has eyes, that is in front of its head. Which is present at its front of its head, and this will enable, or you can say that which enables it to have a correct idea of the location. Correct idea of the location of its prey. So you see, students, that it is having eyes, and that eyes is present in front of the head, and which will help it giving it the correct idea of the location, and due to which they are able to locate, they are able to see the location of the prey, and ultimately it will help them to find the food, or it will help them to find the its prey. Okay, so we can also write that this will helps it to catch its prey. Okay, so it will also help it to catch its prey. So this is the third adaptation that occur in that of the loin, that is eyes. Okay, so we have seen here the first thing, that they are very strong, and they are very strong, and they are very fast, and due to which they are able to take their prey easily, they are able to kill their prey easily. And the second thing, that their claws, they are having very sharp and strong claws, and these sharp and strong claws, it will remain inside to that of the toes. Why it remain inside? To remain protected, so that it will not going to worn out or will become blunt. Okay, so it remain inside, and they use this claws to catch the prey. Then the third one, that they are having eyes, and this eyes are present at the front of its head, and due to which they are able to enable the location. of the prey and able to catch them easily. Then the fourth one is that basically you see students that what is the color of the wood? You will say brown in color. So the color of the loin is also brown in color. What we're going to do with the color? Absolutely, if the color of the forest is also, means woods are also brown in color and the color of the loin is also brown, so this will help the loin. Even if you see the grassland student, dry bushes, so these dry bushes is also brown in color. So if it is brown in color, so it will make the loin to easily hide, okay, or not get easily recognized by its prey. Okay, so they can easily hide themselves, or we can say that this color will easily get blend with the background. Blend with the background, it means the color of the grassland, the dry bushes is also brown. If you look at the stems of the plant, that is also brown in color. So this will help them to hide easily. And due to having the same color, they will be not able to recognize easily by the prey. Okay, so they can hunt the prey by hiding itself in the bushes. So we can write it, that is the color of the loin. Okay, or the loin is light brown in color. It is light brown in color. Then the light brown color helps the loin to hide in the dry bushes. In the bushes, student, dry bushes, or we can say in dry grassland. Dry grassland without being noticed by its prey. So while hunting, it really want do not get a, means it do not want to get recognized by its prey, otherwise it will run away. So what it will the good thing, that is the its color. So its color is actually the color of the bushes, the dry grassland, so that is light brown in color. So they can easily hide itself in the dry bushes, which will make it to hide itself for a longer period of a time. Okay, so these are what, children, these are few adaptations shown by the loin to live in the grassland or in the forest condition. Okay, so we have seen here that if we talk about the loin, so basically the first thing that we see that they are strong, they are very fast, and due to which they are able to hunt the prey. Second thing, that they are having very strong and sharp claws. With the help of which they used to catch its prey, and this sharp claws, it remain inside to that of the toes until and unless it will take out it is not in a use. So they used to keep it inside in order to protect itself from being blunt or from being worn out, okay, torn out. The second one is, then the next one is that if you look at the eyes, so eyes are present at the front of the head, which will make it, which will give idea to the loin about the location of its prey, okay, and help it to recognize easily, help it to recognize the location of the prey, and make it to easily catch the prey. Finally, student, the color. So the color will get easily blend with that of the grassland, which make it to hide itself without being recognized by the prey. So these are some of the adaptations shown by the loin. Now, not only the loin is there, it means not only the predators are there, but prey is also there. It means that not only lion is living there, but deer is also there. And you know that lion is a carnivorous, so deer is a herbivorous. So deer also has adapted itself in such a way that they can protect themselves from the lion. Okay, so adaptation is shown by both of them. One has adapted itself, one has get some of the special feature due to which it can attack on the other, and the second one may have the some features due to which it can protect itself from the attack of its predator. Now let us see what are the adaptations shown by the deer. Adaptation in deer. So the first thing that we should know that deer is what? It is a herbivorous animal. Herbivore. It is a herbivorous animal. So from where it will get its food material? From the plant and its product. Okay. So plant material as food. Now this one also lives in the forest, like we have seen in case of the lion also. So we can see that lives in forest. So this, it is also has adapted itself in such a way that they can live in the forest very easily. What are that, student? What are the adaptation? So you see that when we were talking in case of the lion, that lion is having eyes which is in front of its head, and due to which it is able to which make it to enable the location. What about in case of a deer? Deer is having eyes on the both side of its head, and due to which it make it to see a large area and help it to recognize the location of the predator, and this will make it to protect themselves from that of the predator. Predator is what? Those who kill the other. And prey is what? Which is killed by the predator. Okay, so we can write that eyes, deer is having eyes. The deer has eyes on the side of its head, on the side of its head. It is having eyes on the side of its head which enables it to see in all the directions. Enable it to see in all the direction at the same time. At the same time. Okay, now if it is able to see in all the direction, this will help it to find that any kind of a predator or any kind of a lion is hiding there. So make it to see the location and help it to protect. Okay, so we can write it that the all round vision, the all round vision of deer helps it to see animals like lion. Okay, so they are having the eyes which is present at both the side, and due to which they are able to see the all the directions, and this all-round vision of the deer will help them to see the animals like a lion in all the
area around it.
All the area around it. Okay.